Okay, down here. Here's my new. Let me get down here low. Hello. Okay. So here's my new side splash for my sink, and I'm gonna make a close up here. And I finished. I'll go ahead and do that on here right quick too. I finished. Yeah, I didn't know if the light's gonna be a little different. I was just gonna let this camera run while I work, but you can kind of see that line. It looks like. So you know, I had to cut it off, rounded it off, and everything, and then I resprayed that in. This was the factory finish. Come out, you know, matching pretty well. There's a little bit of tape left on there, which you might see there. But otherwise. These phones don't want to. They want to rotate the wrong way right when you don't want them to. And you have to. Every time I start it, I have to re-hit autofocus. Okay, so. Yeah, here's the close-up of my side splash. After I, it's dried. I had it outside for a week or maybe two, and then I thought, you know, it's cooling. The weather's cooling off. I better bring it in. That's the original finish. And that right there, where you can see that little line, that's where I sprayed it. It came out really nice and smooth. Kind of on accident, I forgot to readjust my spray gun after cleaning it the previous time, so it was shut down real tight. But it was letting out such a fine mist, it ended up being real smooth because. You might be able to see on this one. This one was brushed first and then sprayed quite a few different times. But even that last spray on this one, for some reason, turned out a lot more. Probably because it just didn't get enough on there to cover up the previous one. See those little marks? That's where I had my tripod as in the house. I brought it in the house to let it help with the dry. I had the foot of my tripod sitting on it. And it stuck to it. It wasn't dry yet. I didn't realize. I think warming it up made it, you know, feel more... Might have brought the started bringing the moisture back, the dampness moisture. What, I don't know, not water moisture. Well, maybe, but anyway, maybe it started drying because it didn't feel sticky. I had set my wallet on it; it stuck to it, and I thought it was dry enough to put stuff on. So, and this one stayed outside a week or two after this one. And I kept thinking I didn't want to bring that one in. I didn't really get in my way, you know, but. Thought, well, it's probably not going to dry if I don't bring it in, because I want to use it to test my sanding and see what I can use, because the last time I sanded on this one, I didn't ever try to sand the new one yet. This black 400 grit sandpaper made black all over it, and I've got some different sandpaper here and some Scotch-Brite. Got some Scotch-Brite up there. What's that? That's probably 220. Some more 400. This is some 400 that I had up. That's the same brand, I think. It was up in the front part of the garage, and I thought, well, maybe that's a little different. But yeah, there's no difference here. I'm not really good at doing good at aiming, am I? So yeah, I'm over there off the camera. If I set that camera way, way back, then it, you know, it'd be too far back for it to see anything. So kind of dividing the difference there. So I'm gonna stop this close-up video and get to work. And I'm just going to start off. I was thinking I might use my vibrator sander, and or I might use my drill with some Scotch-Brite on it to buff it. But first, I'm going to just see how it. This rounded off side is going to be the bottom. That's the way you're going to be looking at it. So I'm going to start on the bottom edge with some sandpaper and see. Yeah, I think I won't use any of this used stuff on here. That smooth view, that's 150. I wouldn't mind using that on there. That's 150. That I might use with one of these sanding blocks. I think that's already been used on. It was used on there, I believe. It's got some of that on it. And this little block make a good sanding block. A little scrap of white oak from something I made. That's 150. I was really wanting 220. Yeah, if I'm gonna do that, then yeah, this 220. Yeah, I'll just wrap that around there and try that first, because the black. Well, let's try the black first. Yeah, try the black first. first. I probably ought to put that on here. Should already done. Oh, my! I have cardboard on my saw table to protect it from. Let's see what I did to my view there. It's okay. I have cardboard. I bet you the cardboard on there to protect it from all this crap. This is my saw table I built. It's got a table saw under it. Last thing in the world you want is glue or paint on your saw table. Because then your wood won't, had to get my knife, then your wood won't slide, and that can be very dangerous. So, try to make sure I don't mess that up. So let me get this piece of, I think that's 150 on that. This is a really nice, I guess they're pretty common, I don't know anymore. My tools are old, and it's got little nails in it. It's a rubber block, got nails in it. Got it back in the 70s. 1970s, yeah, the olden days. And so I had it ever since. And I think it was kind of marketed for sanding cars with, you know, stuff like that, doing body work. But trying to, this one's not the usual width. It's been cut the wrong way for the. If you cut it the right way, you can get more of them fit in the sanding block. But, I want it to be too long. I want to have enough left to use for my little wooden block there. I'll cut it crooked. Usually I fold them over and get them, I'm going to bring some back out of there. Fiddly. I'm a little fiddly because I'm not used to messing with this thing anymore. But you push it down and it holds it where you put it. That's and then if it's too wide like that, I just fold it up. That's good when you know sometimes you really want that, have it folded up, because then you won't tear your. You don't tear your sandpaper when you're hitting edges and stuff. Really, that's just only with wood, and you got to worry about that. But now, this is just barely enough to get around there and you can use the wood. Sometimes you want a hard piece of sanding block, and sometimes you want a soft one. At this point, I actually think I do want this. Oh, where's that masking tape? I'm going to do that. Well, I have some wider masking tape somewhere in that drawer, but these will do. I'm these two strips. Tried to get things out ahead of time, but I never remember it all. So I'm going to put my masking tape on here so that I can just get to that edge, but not. That's going to get the backside doesn't matter so much. I'll see. I may be sticking out of the camera, but. I did spray the backside just to kind of keep the water from penetrating it if water gets behind it. But I'll put me a couple of strips on here. Ah, this one's pretty old. Does that all the time. I'm talking quite a few years old. And this is like 50, 51 degrees today, so everything's chilly and not cooperating so well. Tape's usually easier to work with in a warmer weather. Somebody walking by. I'll use this narrow piece. It's brand new. Just pulled it out of the wrapper the last time I was out here working. If I can find the end. I can barely even sit with these glasses on. There we go. Oh, no. I think it's just too cool. If it's going to do the same as the wide one, I might as well fight with the wide one if I'm going to have to fight with one. Got some stuck on my thumb. Tape, the best thing to get something sticky off of you is something that's sticky. So just leave that tape laying around. That's what I, a lot of times I have to leave a piece laying around and use it to get that excess tape off of stuff. But, careful, maybe it'll work. Okay. I'm so worried with this stuff, it's so brittle that I'm, and it's kind of cool. Well, it's been in the house, it's nice and warm. But, I think that's enough. It's so brittle that I'm really worried about. If I drop it, it'd just shatter. Because when I was cutting it, the last little bit would, when I cut these, I didn't, it did a little bit, but this big piece, this is actually the cutoff from the bigger splash, it's the back splash I made. And it broke a good quarter to half inch chunk out, and luckily I was rounding it off enough to get rid of it, the bad spot. But if you were trying to do a real sharp edge, you'd be in trouble with that. Okay, now I'm going to start here, and see, now I'm not sanding on my original finish. Normally I just grab a vibrating sander and go at things, but in this case it's such a small amount. I think it's not going to work out okay. Where's my camera? My other camera. Get it going again. Can't leave these things running with it in camera mode. It runs the battery down in 10 minutes. Matter of fact, you only get about 10, 20, maybe 20 minutes out of a battery making videos. Okay, it's on. There it is. And yeah, it's beginning to blend in okay, I think. I just can't see good enough. I'm going to have to get my magnifying glass. But it's sanding good. It's not... not turning out black. I'm gonna get this in one hand, and I'm gonna try the soft one in this case. If I can do this in one hand and sand with the other, this can set. I'm afraid it's just gonna move. Yeah. Okay, so I can't do that. Turn this little camera off. Okay. I'm gonna set it over here on the sandpaper, so I'll have it ready. So if I like to be on the edge sometimes, but sometimes over the edge of the table, but not, I don't always have to do that. Oh, let me get my, I believe it's thick enough. Yeah, it's, let me look at this. Yeah, just be careful, I'm going to have to be careful not to overdo it on the, and that round, that softer piece may be harder to get a fine hit spot with too. So yeah, I'm sanding off of the edge of the table now. I'm trying to just blend it in without going through it. This is actually the one I could make a mistake on. This is the bottom side that's not actually going to show. I think what I'll have to do, if I expect to shine it up any, is hit it with that scotch brush. I did that piece I had in my room under my TV. It's a big piece. It was out of some like big vanity or something. Vanity sink, vanity top. And There's some scrap. These are not this one. It came with this new sink, but the other pieces were scraps that the guy knew gave me that he got from new construction sites. And, you know, they were cut off of things. Yeah, now that looks like it probably down here towards the bottom went through. That's what I got to be careful about. So, it's a little bit gooey once you start hitting it. See, if you let your deal roll that way, you're sanding. Let me see if my thing got moved. Yeah, I'm okay. Ah. So if you let it roll that way, even a little bit, you're going to mess up. So. And it's already getting gooey. It gets gooey fast. Oh, I saw a U-Haul truck pull up my floor. Somebody's moving, but it's a delivery, a Christmas delivery. Where's Santa? Okay, so... not to me. Not to me this time. I think I've got all mine. Well, I'll probably have a couple of small things coming that are not Christmas. I'm having to use a magnifying glass to see what I'm doing. I'm going to let it set on the tape to maybe keep it more level. I think the hardwood is better on a small edge like this than trying to use that soft one, because it'll give, and you'll end up going, it'll give enough to sand too deep on one side or the other, just kind of wherever it decides to do it. So, let me hit that top edge. I think my tape is, yeah, my tape is right where it was the first time. Actually, it's over it a little bit, so when I do that top edge, I'll have to get some of that tape off of there. I'll just leave it as it is for now. Doing is I'm putting my corner down it just off the edge of the tape and then lifting it up a little to try and blend without going, you know, through on my rounded edge or on close to the edge there. I'd rather have a little bit of a, I don't want a groove there, but I'd rather have a little groove there than going through it. I'll flatten it out again. Can't really keep it flat that way. I want to hit it with this once or twice just to see what it feels, see what it looks like after I hit it. It's not doing too bad at all. Be careful though. It already hit the bottom on the back end, side towards me. And with it out there on the tape like that, it kind of... Yeah, I'm still a little scared of that. Okay. I took it down. I'm stopping there. And I will hit that with Scotch-Brite. That end is... Oh! I thought it was messed up. It was just some stuff, sanding debris. Okay, so get this camera out again. Phone, camera. To me, they're just cameras. Where's the button? Okay. There. something, you can shake it and it'll go back. Okay, ready for your close-up?
Okay, so you can still see a little bit of that line there. But I'm going to start buffing it because I'm really worried about going through it. And I'll just wait and do that end after I get that top part, because I'm going to have to just... my tape ended up, I didn't see it. It's actually just a hair over what I'm trying to sand. And so, you know, it's just in the right place on this side, but I'd forgotten that it had curved. See, because of my rounded off edge, I had to curve that masking tape. It went like this, and then I, you know, turned a little corner there. The original one when I sprayed it. So,
let's go back to work there. Whoops. Trying to figure out where's the best place to put my phone. I don't like to lay that. I guess that's not a good place. I don't like to lay. I'm going to turn it, put the slick, put it in my pocket. I'm afraid I'll knock it off and break it or something. But I didn't want the camera laying on the dirty workbench, you know. Okay, now what have I got in the lab? Got a few different kinds of. These have been used a lot. Probably too used up to be much good. This is an interesting one. I don't think it would want to use it for that. It's fairly rough, but it's a rubber foam sanding pad. It's been used quite a bit, so it's, these are pretty smooth, these yellow ones. So yeah, I'm kind of scared to get out my drill and go to town on it anyway. You know, I have some over there in my drill kit of drill stuff. Let's see, it's one of these. And I will use it to buff things. But I'm still worried about going through it. So. Much as I don't like, well, I was a cabinet maker. I didn't do hand sanding. Everything was a belt sander or a vibrator. We didn't use drill sand, you know, discs and make wood because of the cross grain. Of course, this is not wood, so it wouldn't matter in that case. But you don't have to worry about cross graining. You just want it good and smooth. In this case, I might be able to take the tape off and actually get to it better. But I wanted to see what it was going to start looking like first. I may have to do some more sanding with the sandpaper. But I was saying before, I kind of stopped telling. I've buffed this stuff before. And I belt sanded that piece and then I buffed it. Can't tell. I mean, trying to get some fresh paper on it. I buffed it to the point that it was shiny. You can do it without, you know. Actually, back then I didn't look into. I thought that's kind of probably figured that's how they did it when they cut, you know, bathroom tops and stuff. I didn't do any research back then and found out. Well, I wasn't going to do it anyway, but. That they spray it with this gel coat. Once I learned that on this one, I wanted it to be just like that backsplash piece. I wanted it to be just like the sink, same color, you know, blend right in. So I did a bunch of research and found out exactly what was considered the best quality gel coat. Well, first I had to find out what they put on them, and it turned out it's gel coat like they use on boats. Fiberglass. Okay, I think it's time to peel some tape back now. And, I'll just go ahead and peel that tape back. I started grabbing a little good camera, but you can't hardly feel it. You can still see it. But you can't really feel it. I'll just peel the tape off and then show it. I'll just peel it all the way off because I'll peel this layer off maybe. It's underneath the other one. Yeah, not gonna be able to do it. I don't think I need it anymore. I think I've done enough heavy duty sanding to leave it off of there. Maybe on that corner, I don't know, I might want tape didn't want to come off. I want to scrape this with my knife, so scratch it up. Rub it off. Rubbing on it heats it up, makes it let go. There we go. Get some of this other tape. Okay, so. Which one I was using that one, I think. Okay, so. Ooh, I nearly dropped that camera. No matter what I do.
Am I still recording over there?
Yeah. Okay. This to me is about the trickiest part of this whole thing. Well, mixing that darn gel coat right to make it where it dry was hard.
Okay, so. You can hardly feel it. I can feel where the tape was more than I can feel that. You can still see a little mark there. So I'm going to try to blend that in with Scotch-Brite. That's the underside. And I don't know if you can tell, but right back there it started going through, but it doesn't matter. It's going to be not going to be seen. I haven't tried this part right here yet. Actually, my tape was covering the edge. So I'm going to freehand that. I think I can do that fine. Now that I got the feel for it, I think I can do it without the tape. Stop this close up. Now, I'm really having to use the. Let me try this piece. I don't even remember which piece I was using now. I'm really having to use the. Magnifying glass to see what I'm doing. That's putting green on it. That could be hard to get off. What a bunch of crap. Okay. Which one's the one? Okay, this one. Well, you know, it's not looking scratched, so I think I'm going to stick with just the sandpaper. I think I'm getting a better look that way. Under the magnifying glass, you can see some tiny scratches. Freaks my eyes out looking through this glass and having my hand go by there. Okay, I think I'll move. Oh no, let's leave it on right there. As long as you can feel it when it starts getting too sticky to use anymore, you can feel it. Kind of dragging. Feel the bumps in it too, and when it starts sticking to the paper. If you ever done any refinishing, you'll know you go through paper really fast. If you don't change your paper, then you will make a mess out of what you're working with. And this is kind of the same thing. Hard to
sand across it. But if you go up, you know, left and right, then you get probably get too much area. This is the top side. This is the one that shows the most. But I think left and right's better. I can see it's hitting a little more back there. Of course, I'm going to be caulking this top back edge, that's the front edge. And there is actually a little dimple in it right there too that I'm not going to get rid of. Where there was, I guess, an air bowl that popped. That I didn't know about till it was too late, till I'd done my last coat. I hit it with this one for a minute. Let's see. Shit. Went through. Right on the top. Well, most of it will be covered by caulk. So there you go. It's always in the worst place when something like that happens. Better quit. Better quit while I'm ahead. There's still a little tiny line there. Another camera, not sure. People driving around today. This is a pretty quiet neighborhood, but I guess there's more noise around here than I realized. Old growing zone. Well, there's people that work, do their business from home and stuff. People, my neighbors across the street, air conditioning guy, and they're always coming around. Alright, there's a close up. This is where I'm going to have to leave it because what I'm gonna hang it off the edge and see if that whatever makes it focus the best is what I'm trying to do. Right there, that is where I went through. But most of that will still be covered with caulk. I'll have almost a quarter inch bead of caulk up there. Maybe not. I wasn't gonna do much of it. My bead of caulk was gonna be as thin as possible, but I may allow it to be. And that's where it started to go through a little on the bottom, but it's worse on the top. Don't you know? I guess I should, well, it's really on the rounded edge. I hit it a little hard on the rounded edge. So my tape really wouldn't have saved me in that case. I just let it, I was sanding like that, and it was more pressure down there, and I didn't realize it. I was trying to get rid of that little line right there, but it was actually giving, well, of course, it was probably just thinner there, too. You don't really know just how thick your finish is, you know. Can't know that, so. That's as good as I think I'm going to get it. I don't want to go through it. It's not a, something you can really even feel. So, once it's cleaned, I think there's a little, you know, dirt in there. Once it's cleaned real good, I think it'll be good. Okay, you know, you're not going to be standing up there eyeballing it with a magnifying glass. So that's as good as I can do. Pretty tricky thing, really, to blend. To that original finish with your new sprayed finish of this gel coat. My first try at gel coat period and my first try at doing that. Alright, it's done. Okay, so back to the work. I'm going to take it in there in a little bit. I want to hit it with this green Scotch-Brite again, but that will probably just, I'll try this yellow. I don't think it'll make colors on it. I'm afraid it'll just make that green, and I've gotten that on that other piece. I actually was going to practice on that piece first, and I forgot. That's alright. It's making yellow on it. So I'm afraid that that's going to be hard to get off, is my thing. Seems like it was on that other piece when I was on that practice piece, but also it wasn't as dry as it should be. Hit it very lightly just to try to get that yellow off. Hey, blend it in a little more too.
see the green still. So I believe that that green will wash off. I think. So I'm gonna quit before it's too late. I'm always. It's easy to just think, oh, just a little more, and that's usually when you make your big mistake. Same thing with spraying. I'm not that great at spraying because I want to cover it and get it done, and so I'll just keep hitting it and hitting it, and then you get big old runs. This here, I think I'm gonna go ahead. Let me see if I'm still running. Yeah. Okay. So I want to see. Where's that 100? Yeah, 220. I'm gonna hit it with 220. Right there where my wallet. I'm thinking about using this as a coaster. Yeah, coaster. Because I thought about putting it in the kitchen to set hot pans on, but I don't think this stuff is really good for hot. That's actually. Where is it? That spot there. You can feel it pretty good because I got my utility knife when it was in my room there. That one's just where my wallet sit on. That's some leather. But that was some stuff off the bottom of my... It was actually, I have some sticky things that had Velcro on them. On the bottom of the... I had that thing Velcroed to the top of my monitor one time when I was shooting some video. With a weather webcam before I got these things here. These phones. Anyway, that is... Among other rough spots, a rough spot. Can sand it off. And it seems a lot more dry than when that happened. Doesn't take any time whatsoever to start getting gooey in your sandpaper when you're sanding this one. Well, really when you're sanding any of this. Couple of, there's a dark spot down there on that edge where something got on it. And then, this is pretty thick. I could probably sand. It's been brushed and then sprayed and sprayed. I kept using it as my, you know, test my spray pattern and everything. So you could probably sand on this until you got it fairly smooth, but it's way more work than I want to do for a coaster. Starts rolling up real quick into little pieces of this stuff, and if you keep rubbing on that, it'll just put more dark on. It's starting to make it look worse instead of better already. So let's grab. I don't know if there's much left usable in here, but this 400. I don't actually know if I want to mess. I might use that. Well, it's already used enough. Yeah, I'll hit it with this. After I've knocked the high spots off of it, I'll probably just try to use some cleaner to get the dark places out. There's something I can feel there on that side. I think it must have got hit while it was wet. There's something sticking out, and then once I sanded it off, you could feel the divots in there. The spot where I think there was some of that gooey stuff on the outside edge, too. I'm putting more pressure on that corner to try to get those little spots out. That I shouldn't have dug around. That stuff was, like I said, it pulled some of that gooey junk off the bottom of my tripod lids and stuck it on there, and I didn't want that left in there. But what I did was dig into the wet, you know, damp, gooey, kind of sticky
gel coat. So it really wasn't a good idea the way I should have probably left it alone. Waited till for a week or two for it to dry and then got some cleaner to clean it off. Now as far as the leather from the wallet, that's working out fine. And I didn't touch it, I left it alone. But this would have done better if I would have left it alone, clean, and then like use some cleaner. And then sanded it. Yeah, there's all kinds of little bitty baby holes in there. Of course, if you can see how, if I can show how rough this is, then you'll see why. It's a lot better than it was, at least. But it looks like, I mean, if you were to get some stain, I think it'd look almost like wood grain. I thought that might be an interesting idea. Or like if you had, if you're real industrious and you wanted to play with your coaster a long time, you could get a different color of gel coat and brush it on and then wipe it off. Well, I don't think you can wipe it off. Maybe you could spray it very, very lightly and leave it at that. Now look at that. That's how quick your sanding pad will get gummed up where you can't use it. Edge there. Still got something in it. So I'm gonna call that done for a coaster. And I mean it would be real good for me to set my big old drink on. But I'll get my drink. Here's the problem with that. So if I were gonna set my drink on it, it'd be just right. But I've got two drinks. Yeah, they might go like that, but I like to keep them like that. They'll just fit, but this is going to get turned over, and that would be a mess. It's just not big enough. If it was a little bit bigger, and it's too big to do like that, then on my desk, I won't have room up here for the other one. I know, it doesn't matter. That's neither here nor there. But there we go. So now I'm going to go in and go ahead and get my caulking out and put this in. I think I will. I gotta have a drink of coffee. I think I'll. Yeah, I'm gonna. Well, I don't wanna get it wet though. Yeah, I'm not even gonna. I was thinking I would, you know, put a little Windex on it and clean it up, but I'll just wipe it down, keep it dry, so that my caulking will stick good. I can see where I sanded there. After I took my tape off, now I can really see. Probably wouldn't have been a good. Would have been a better idea to not take the tape off and hit it at all. See that tape on there? Probably should have just adjusted where the tape was here. Yeah, if I would have, I don't know if that would have, yeah, it might have helped, might not have, but, you know, if I wouldn't have tried to freehand that and have my tape on there, it could have saved me from messing that up. I thought, oh, I'm pretty good. I can freehand it. But, like I said, I really don't know. As far as getting off and getting too deep right there, I can't say that, you know, tape would have really saved me. But it, I do think having it on there at the beginning did save me from messing up that big main front side. But, there's one little spot where I keep wanting to hit it again. I better leave it alone. Yeah. And those little tiny little scratches, if that darn Scotch-Brite wouldn't putting its color off into it, I would buff it with that. But I'd rather live with those little scratches that you can't see unless you look really close. And that green, trying to get that green off of there, I just don't know if I can. There's another piece of dark Scotch-Brite. This is weird stuff. It flakes off real bad. Now, it was dark to start with. It's not exactly like this other Scotch-Brite. This piece here is too rough. That won't do any good. Yeah, I'm not going to hit that with that green again. I did it on that other piece before, and I really got a lot of green on it. And it was hard to get off from what I remember. It's been a month or two. But, yeah, this is ready to take in and hook and put in. That's what I'm gonna do. And that will be my poster. Still see some spots that look like they would probably need to be sanded out to be got rid of. I don't think they would wash out. It's when you hit, don't dare hit this stuff when it's still kind of not dry enough, because that's when all that horrible black got in this and couldn't get it out from this sample. And I mean, this thing, the first two, I wait like a day or two between coats. I put two or three coats on this and the other big splash. And I ended up letting it dry for a month and a half, 2 months, before it got dry enough to not be able to, you know, still feel a little sticky in there. And I think that is mostly to do with my mix, because this mix I got real, I know I got it good because it was really showing good signs of drying by the next couple days. And after I brought it in the house, it dried up real good. And then you just, and you know, it's been at least a month though. Been in the house for 2-3 weeks. If the weather had still been hot, I'd have left it out here, but the weather got cooled off, you know. Last week we had it down in the 20s, some high 20s, mid 20s, mostly like 32 to 35 for about, actually it was 2 days ago. Yesterday it went up from 45 to 75 yesterday, today it's 50. 75, yesterday was nice, but I didn't get to be outside. I was outside a little bit, but not long, because I was doing something in the house. So, alright, there we go. I'm going to go put it in, and I'll try to make another install video. All right.